Hello students, today we are going to conduct an experiment on load test on an induction generator, that is to run the induction motor as an induction generator and determine the efficiency of the generator. The overall setup to conduct this experiment is as shown in this video. The machines which are required to conduct this experiment are a 3-phase induction motor with a rating 5 HP and 415 volt, which is coupled to a DC generator of rating 3.7 kilowatt 220 volt. This DC machine can be run as a DC generator as well as DC motor. So the overall circuit diagram to conduct this experiment is as shown in the circuit here. As per this circuit, we have connected the whole circuit. From a 3-phase mains, we have connected an auto transformer, and the output of the auto transformer is given to the 3-phase induction motor, and which is in turn coupled to a DC generator. And we have used at the input side an energy meter which shows the direction of the supply, whether it is from left to the right, that is from supply to the 3-phase induction motor, or from induction generator to the supply. So this aluminium disc, if it is rotating from left to right, it indicates the induction motor is getting the supply. If it is rotating from right to left, it shows that the induction motor is acting like an induction generator and it is giving the supply back to the mains. So we have used wattmeters, two wattmeters W1 and W2 to measure the input power given to the induction motor. We have used a DPST switch to synchronize the generated voltage from the generator with the external DC supply. The external DC supply terminals are connected here, plus, minus, and the generated EMF from the DC generator is connected here as plus, minus. Once both the voltages become equal, we can close this switch to synchronize. So the overall idea about this experiment is to run the 3-phase induction motor initially, which is coupled to a DC generator. Now DC generator is driven by a 3-phase induction motor, then DC generator starts developing an EMF that can be checked by making use of a DC voltmeter. By making use of a field rheostat which is kept initially in cut-in position, so gradually varying this, we can excite the field of a DC generator and we can bring the voltage induced in the DC generator to its rated voltage by looking into voltmeter connected across the switch. The rated voltage of this external DC supply is 220 volt. When both the voltages become equal, we will close the DPST switch, then we will be synchronizing the supply, external DC supply, with the generated voltage of the DC generator. Then by cutting it again, the field of the DC shunt generator will make generator to run more than its rated speed, that is more than 1500. Once the generator start acting as a DC motor, its speed increases. That can be done by making use of a field rheostat of a DC machine. So once it become equal to 1500, the energy meter disc starts rotating in the opposite direction. It will stop rotating first, and then still if we increase the rheostat of the field of a DC machine, so the energy meter disc starts rotating in the opposite direction. It means the DC shunt generator is acting as a DC motor, and it is in turn driving the induction motor. That is, at that instant, induction motor, 3-phase induction motor, starts acting as an induction generator. So by absorbing the aluminium disc which is rotating in the opposite direction, it shows the energy is transferred from induction generator to the supply. Before starting the experiment, we should confirm the zero position of the auto transformer. We should keep it for zero position, then we should switch on the main supply. Then we have connected a voltmeter, an ammeter and a DC ammeter and the field current. Then RPM can be read by making use of this RPM meter. The overall setup we can see in this video. Now gradually vary the auto transformer from 0 to the rated voltage of 415 volt. The motor start rotating. Slowly vary the auto transformer and see that it is running at a rated voltage of 415 volt. So it is 400. Now slowly increase the auto transformer and make that voltage to 415 volt. Now we can observe in the energy meter that the disc is rotating from left to right. The red band in the aluminium disc shows that the energy meter disc is rotating from left to right, that is energy transfers from auto transformer to the three phase induction motor. So the initially AC supply current is read as 5.19 and the total RPM of the DC generator is 1496. Now the wattmeter shows the input power drawn by the induction motor. Now as we have connected the terminals of the DC generator AAA across this voltmeter, it is showing some generated voltage, but it is not equal to the rated value of 220 volt. Now vary the field rheostat of the DC shunt generator and make this voltage equal to 220 volt. So gradually vary the field rheostat of the DC shunt generator from cut in to cut out position such that it shows a generated voltage of 220. So this is equal to 220. Now switch on the DC supply, external DC supply, which is also having a rating of 220 volt. Now check the voltage of DC voltmeter which is connected to the DC supply, external DC supply. Here also we can see the 220 volt supply. When both the voltages are equal, then close the DPST switch. Now both the voltages generated by the DC generator and the external DC supply are in synchronization. Now by varying the field rheostat of the DC generator and by rotating it into cut-in position, we will see the increase in the RPM of the DC generator, which crosses beyond 1500, and the field current of the DC generator also starts increasing. So now start increasing the field of the DC generator and we will make it to work as a DC motor. And just see, the aluminium disc of the energy meter stops rotating. Further cutting in the rheostat of the field, we can make the RPM increasing of a DC generator. So it is going beyond 1500. So the RPM increased. Now at this instant, this DC generator starts operating as a DC motor, and now it is driving the induction motor. Means this induction motor now acting as a induction generator, and we can see that the aluminium disc has stopped. Further, by increasing the field of a DC generator, the aluminium disc start rotating in the opposite direction. So at each position of the rheostat, we can note down the input watts W1, W2, and also the input voltage given to the induction motor, generated voltage 450 volt, then the AC current, then the field current DC, then the RPM. So RPM can be increased slowly in step of 3 to 4 RPMs. So we have to load the induction generator in step of 3 to 4 RPMs. So gradually, by varying the field rheostat of the induction generator. So at each step, at each RPM, in step of 3 to 4 RPM, as we load the induction generator, all the readings are noted down. That is, the VDC, IDC, speed in RPM, W1, W2, and IDC. And remaining parameters are calculated by using the formula given in the manual. Now, to shut down the experiment, we have to reverse all the procedures. Now, make this DC current 0. It is in 6.8 now. Now, make this 0 so that it draws a 0 current DC machine. After making this current 0, now we should open the DPST switch. We should make IDC nearly equal to 0. Now we should open the DPST switch. Again, switch off the DC supply. Then the field rheostat is brought again to its original position, that is cut-in position. Then gradually varying the auto transformer, that is from 415 volt, we should reduce it back to 0 just by reducing the auto transformer. Bring the auto transformer back to 0 position and switch off the main supply. This completes the load test on 3-phase induction generator.